Now we will do an exercise about recursive method, and we will write the following method. It says, write a recursive method that will retain the number of digits in a number. And it says, public static integer count digits integer n. So if you have your number n, you have to count how many digits there. And then you have to modify it to calculate only the number of odd digits. And also you have to write it as a recursive method. So remember, we cannot use any for or while loop or any type of loop. I have to always use a recursive method where I should have a base case, and also we should have a general case where we keep calling the method. So let's start with the first one, public static integer n, and I have to count how many digits. So if I need to do this, I will take a number n. For example, if I say the number as 32, it means I have to count how many digits. I have two digits. So here the output we have to return as an integer, which is 2. If the value of n is 5, 6, 8, it means here we have 3 digits, so I have to output the 3. So let's think about it in this way. I will have n, for example, as 56, and then I have to count how many digits. Usually when you need to deal with digits, you have to go and change n such that you divide by 10. So you will have to say, I will call my method and I will change n by saying n over 10. So the next time you call your method, the value of n will be 5, because when you divide by 10, it means the right digit, which is 6, will be removed. And again here you will have to say, call the method and send n over 10. So when you call it, and here you divide 5 by 10, you will reach the value as 0. So once you divide, you will just, each time you will get rid of the digits. So the first time it will be, for example, if it is 5, 6, 8, the second time it will be 5, 6, and then 5, and then it will be as 0. Now here what I need to do, I need to count how many digits. So I have to have more like, whenever we have a number, I will say we found 1, and then I will call the method. So here I will say, because this number is not 0, so I have at least 1 digit, and I will call my method, and then I will say plus. When I go to the second call, I will say again I have 1 digit, and I will continue. When I reach 0, I have to say I finish all the digits. So here I have to stop, and I have to say return 0. When you return 0 and you go back, then you will do the summation of the number. So here you will take this 0 there, and you will say 0 plus 1 is 1. So you have to return the result. So the result here will be 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. Return the result and you will have the output as 2. So you found 2 digits in this case. So now, what is the base case? The base case, if n is 0, you have to stop and you have to say return 0. Otherwise, each time you have to say I found 1 digit and I have to continue. By the meaning of continue, as you need to call the method and you have to reduce the number of digits. So if we will take it in a more example way, I can say here, for example, if n is 5, 6, 8, I will say I have 1 digit, and again I will change the value of n. N will be 56 because we divide by 10. So here I will say I found 1 digit, and I will continue, and the value of n will be 5. Again you will say I have 1 digit, and I will continue, and when I reach 0, this is the end. So I have to say we found nothing, so it's more like 0, and I will go back and I will say 0 plus 1, 1 plus 1 plus 1, and then the result you will get at the end is a 3, because here we have 3 digits. Now, how can we write the coding of this one? The method header, it says public static integer, because we need to return an integer. The name of the method is count digits, and I have to take n as an integer. My base case, if you reach 0, you have to stop and you have to return 0. So I'm saying if the value of n is less than or equal to 0, return 0. So you have no digits. We finish all the digits. Otherwise, I will say I have one, but I need to continue by saying call the same method. So remember, always the same method should match the one at the top. And between a bracket, I have to send n, but I have to modify it by saying over 10. So each time you will get rid of one number. One small thing we have to remember when we write recursive method that returns a value as always we should have the keyword return. Because at the end, always I have to take the value and return it to the previous call. So that's why in the base case we have return 0. In the general case we have to return 1 plus the naming of the method. Now let's modify the recursive method we did. And instead of counting all the digits, we need to count only how many odd digits we have. So for example, if we have the value of n as 5, 6, 8, 3, it means I have to count how many odd digits I have, which is in our case 3 and 5, so I have to return 2. The value of n, for example, is 42. I have no odd digit, so we will return 0. So we will follow the same concept we did. So we will follow the same concept we did before, which is counting the digit, but we will modify it such that it will only do the counting of the odd digit. So let's take a number as follows. So we will say here, for example, I have the following case. I have n, let's say we have 41. So 41, we have two digits, but only one of them is odd, so the return should be 1. Here I should have an if condition, and I have to say, if the number we are having is odd number, then I have to do the counting. So I will say I have one digit, and I will continue. By continue, it means we will call the method, and we will send on over 10, just like the previous time. So the second time, the value of n, we will have it as 4. Now we will have an if condition. It says, if your number is odd, our number is not odd in this case, our number is even. If the number is even, then do not do the counting. So here, if you say 1 plus, it means you are doing the counting. So I will not say 1 plus, but all what I have to do is I have to continue by saying call the method and send n over 10. And here, when we call the method and we will reach n as 0, it means we finish all the values we have. When you reach 0, we will return 0, just like what we did in the previous time. So I will take this 0 there. So here we have to return only the result of the call, which is 0. So I have nothing to be added, no plus, nothing. So we will take the 0 up there. So this is 0. 0 plus 1, return the value of this. And we will return the value of 1. So 1 represents how many odd digits we found, which is only 1 in this case. And this is correct. So the idea is take your number. So for example, our number, let's say we have 385. And then always check if the digit is odd. You have to say 1. If it is not, you just continue. So here, for example, if it is a 385, the 5 is odd, so I will say 1, and then I will say plus, continue. The number will be changed, it will be 38. 38 is not an odd number, so I will not do any 1. It's more like I'm saying 0 plus, so I will continue, and I will have the number as a 3. Because I have a 3, I will have 1, and then I will continue, and I will reach the number as 0. Now, when I reach 0, this is the end, so I will go back and I will say, do the summation of 0, plus 1, plus nothing, plus 1, and here why the result we will have it at the end as 2, because I have 2 odd numbers. So the coding will be as follows. My base case is, if n is 0, return 0, so this is the base case as we did before. Now the general cases, I have 2 general cases. If it is odd, what I have to do? If it is even, what do we have to do? If it is an odd number, you have to apply the condition if n modulus 2 equal 1. So this means if this is an odd number, as we agreed, I would say I have 1. and I will call my method and I will send n over 10. Else, if it is not an odd number, it means it's an even number. If it is an even number, you don't have to say 1 plus because we don't need the counting. All what I have to say is return the name of the method n over 10. So here, if we just simply add plus 1, it means I will do the counting of all odd and even numbers. So it will be more like the previous version. And also here, always we need to remember that always we should have the return keyword, because by this, we are returning the number at the end.